Okay. So the problem statement is, if opportunity stage is closed on
W-O-N.
Then create a contract
contract
for opportunity and account. Use full stop. Try and catch block. Read the statement. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah. Read this statement.
Yeah, I'm present. If opportunity stage is closed one, then create a contact for opportunity and then account as well.
Right.
Use
so
try and catch.
In both cases, if we are creating or we are updating opportunity stage with closed one, we need a contract should be created and that should be visible in the related list of opportunity and account. Okay.
Retrieveness.
I'm sorry.
What did you say that word? Retrieveness?
I'm saying if in both the cases for the insert and update of opportunity, if the stage is closed one and we need to create a contract by our code for as a child of opportunity and account. Okay. Go to Salesforce. Go to Salesforce UI.
Yeah.
Open contract, yes. Click on new. So we have here account. Wait. We have here account name. That means account is the parent of contract, but we don't have the option of opportunity. So we will be creating one relationship with opportunity. So create a lookup relationship with opportunity.
Okay. So, yeah, Prashant. Okay.
Okay, now go to developer console. Create a trigger with the name create contract on opportunity. Okay, now give me the control. Okay.
Yeah.
Any doubt? Hello.
And the opportunity and account both, right?
Good question. So basically, contract has the parent account,
mm-hmm.
and that's a must.
Okay.
We have to, you know, the create the contract by giving the parent name, account name.
Okay. Is it a lookup relationship between account and contract?
Mulima, go to the Salesforce UI.
Yeah. We created.
And go to the record. Go to new contract, new. See here.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
So that's why we have to create the mm-hmm. account. I mean mm-hmm. the contract for a account. Understood?
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Now go to the dev console. Okay. Now. And one more thing. In opportunity, we will give the account name. So our contract will be created for this account name. Okay. Okay, Sultan.
Yeah.
Okay.
And it is yeah. like out of the box question. Can we relate a hierarchical relationship between these three objects?
Hierarchical relationship in these three objects means?
Like account, opportunity, contract.
Okay. So what is the hierarchical relationship?
It's in between the common field between these three records. We can create a relationship.
Purnima?
Yeah.
What is the hierarchical relationship?
It creates lookup, might be.
Huh?
Between objects. It generally it is a lookup relation between the users, I think. Between users.
Yes, that's true. This field is only available on the user object, right?
Yeah, okay.
But what is the another name of the hierarchical relationship?
Joint, I think.
Abhishek?
Lookup relationship.
No. Lookup relationship is okay, but hierarchical relationship, what do you understand by the hierarchical relationship?
Means so the features of the parent object will get to child object also.
Matri?
It will automatically link with other object.
Automatically? How?
Because it's a lookup, right?
No, what is hierarchical relationship? I just want a simple answer of the hierarchical relationship. Automatically, through programming, through Google, I don't know. Simple answer of hierarchical relationship, which we have studied.
It's the specific relationship on user objects, actually.
You are right. But when I want to know a little bit more, because you are right that this hierarchical relationship field is only available on the user object. You are absolutely right. But what is the and the name of the hierarchical relationship? This question is for Purnima, because you, I'm not saying to Abhishek, but Sultan and Maitri, you guys have forgotten about the hierarchical relationship, unfortunately.
It's a letter start with, it's a word start with J, joining relation.
Don't go into the notes.
Okay.
Joint relationship, or you are trying to say junction relationship?
Junction?
Junction is a different thing.
No, different one.
Okay.
Self? Self?
Self?
Self? Self?
Self? Okay.
Okay. Purnima. Mayati Sultan can't.
Yeah.
No. I expect the answer from you. It's a discussion between the Purnima and me only. Purnima.
Okay.
So, you are right. We have a specific field to create a relationship on the user object, and that user will be, you know, you will create a another assign another user as a parent. So that's a hierarchical, and we have a field on a user object. But we can create, you know, a self relationship, if you remember, on an object. Self relationship, which will behave similar to the hierarchical relationship.
You
remember?
Yeah.
Other can please Google or wherever you have written the about the relationship, you can get the answer. Thanks, Purnima. So, now I need to first check if the opportunity stage is close one, right? Yes. Okay. So as usual, I will be first checking. Line number 7. Any doubt in this?
No.
Okay. Now. Any doubt at line number 8?
No.
Okay.
We don't need to go to user
interface. Go to the Salesforce UI and get the value of the stage name. Close one. क्या हो रहा है आप लोगों को ना पूरे में वे क्या कर रहे हो
क्लोज टू वन यू नीड अ वैल्यू
नो हाउ यू विल कॉपी द वैल्यू क्लोज वन नो वी आर लर्निंग न्यू थिंग्स एंड यू आर फॉरगेटिंग ऑल द डिस्कशन व्हिच वी हैव डन सो फार ऐसा नहीं करो
Last one. Closed one.
Yeah. Last one.
Yeah, person.
One question before I write the code. Shall we go for a revision of the admin part?
Yeah.
No, sometimes Prashant, you all are working daily, even a second you all working. I am touching in a day just for 10 minutes or 5 minutes. How can I that much expect? Just think on me.
But Purnima, the question is, if we are, we are just about to complete our triggers, then the test class, then the asynchronous, then the lightning. This whole syllabus will get complete. But the ultimate purpose of learning the Salesforce, do you think that that will be solved? We all need a job, right?
Yeah.
And yeah. If you will get the job, then only you will be remembering me in your good books. Otherwise, it is the truth. Whoever so teaches, gives a teaching, ultimate fault is of teacher.
But you are correct, Prashant. But it's different. I'm working another job as well. I'm coming home and making a time for this. And some goals are running inside here, so it takes some time for me.
I understand. Okay, so for Saturday Sunday, we will revise our admin part, and we all know the concept of the admin part. We just need a revision, so we will arrange the time for that.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so till here, any doubt?
No.
Okay. Now we have the opportunity, the stage name is close one, right?
I have one more doubt, Prashant. When we are using map, and when we are using set, and when we are using list.
Okay, I will answer you this question. First, understand this code. And then I will tell you, right? So here we have seen that, okay, this opportunity has the stage name has closed on. Now
New contract. Okay.
We are creating the instance of contract.
Contract.
Yeah. Any doubt in this line?
No.
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 Okay. Now,
why it is not giving? In contract, there is a field account name.
Yeah, what your question?
So here, CT dot account ID you have given. Are you given?
Yes. Actually, whenever we find the record, you know, then we go with the IDs. So that's the reason. Okay, just recall the SQL query where we are referring the account.id. So whenever we are referring any of the, you know, the parent, we will always go with ID.
Okay.
Okay. Now I'm assigning the account ID, same account ID of the, which actually we have opportunity account ID. Yes. So we will have the both the same parent for the contract account as well, and for the opportunities account as well, same account we have. Right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Now go to the Salesforce UI. Open the contract, click on new. So, okay, so one we have given, that's a account. Now status, contract start date, contract term date, and opportunity contract. These we have to give, okay? Now, okay, go to Dev Console.
Opportunity contract means?
It's a lookup relationship which we have created. Okay. Lookup relationship which we have created, so that when our opportunity will be created or updated and the stage will be closed on, the contract will be created automatically. And the contract will be child of that opportunity. Okay?
Okay.
We have status. And we have a draft value, right? Why it is not coming now?
Yeah.
And let's take another one.
Today plus two means?
I will explain you.
After 2 days.
I will explain you.
Extra 2 days.
Why it is not working? CT. Let's go there.
If you log in through your own laptop for the same org, that will be easy for you to work, right?
I already have a lot of the triggers, so you might...
No, for same this org. I'm telling about this org itself.
Okay.
Punimos org.
We'll try next time. So we have the contract term. And that's a number. So till here, I have not done anything, any special. I have just created the instance of a contract because I'm creating a new contract. I have given the account ID to the make on. So till here, I have not done anything special because we are creating a new contract that will be child of the account as well as the opportunity. So I have created an instance at line number 10 of a contract where I have assigned the account which will have the same account which we have on the opportunity. OP is the variable of
opportunity.
Then I have given the name status started. So system.today, if we have to give the date format, we have to write it with a system.today. If you will not use the system and you will write today, this will be a error. I am giving a plus two. That means whatever the date we have today, so plus two, let's say 24 is the today date, so you will get 26. Contract term, I am just giving the any of the number, and this is the relationship, custom relationship which we have created on the contract, who's and making the parent opportunity. So I'm assigning the opportunity ID. Which opportunity? Here in the
same opportunity,
right? Okay, now my most of the things are very, you know, very much ready now. I have created one list of contract type and I am adding that particular contract into that list. Okay.
Okay.
Now. Okay, now I have my new contract data in the list. So I am inserting that. Okay, let's test the code first and then I will explain you if you have any doubt. And after that, we will understand on the same code how to use try and catch block. Okay, so Purnima, test this code. Go to the Salesforce UI.
Yes.
It is already saved. It is already saved. Go to opportunity. First, create a new opportunity. Give the opportunity name. Yes. Give the account name. Close one. And give the account name. Wait. And now click on save. Scroll down. So you have new contract here. Automatically created by your code. Now open this contract in a new tab. Now, account name is the same which Purnima has given for that particular opportunity account.
Yeah.
Contract start date.
26th.
Status and contract term. 12.
Yeah.
Opportunity contact, test opportunity TRI. Okay, now go to the opportunity again. And create one more opportunity whose status should be different.
Stage or status?
Stage. Anything. Yeah. But not close one. Give the wait. Why you are forgetting about the account?
Yeah.
Now save. Scroll down. No. Okay. Now change the stage of this opportunity to close one. Save. And scroll down.
It has created.
Okay. Open the record and check the data.
Added 2 days.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, go to the code and understand this code, because I am going to make you write a code on different object right in front of me. So understand this code, and after that I will tell you how to use the try catch and what's the purpose of using try catch. So let me know wherever you face difficulty.
As inserted, okay. So this is list contract and added.
You have created a list at line 7 of type
okay.
contract. Now you are creating a new contract. So you have added that particular contract into a list.
Mm.
And then you at line number 21, you are running a insert DML on that particular list.
Okay.
Any doubt?
No.
Sultan?
No.
How is it possible? So nobody has.
Why?
Like CT.contract term, it is a hard coding, right? Like you are putting value.
Which contract term? Yes.
Okay.
That's a number. So you can give anything. See, if your logic comes anything like some other logic where you don't need to give the hard code, you can just assign the value like here in the start date I have given the today date plus 2. I'm not hard coding the date here. Abhishek, where is he?
Oh, sorry, Prashant, I'm on mute.
Okay, so, bhai, any doubt?
No, Prashant, no.
Okay, so now we will see the try catch block. So it.
Okay.
The best practices, I have mentioned the point, always use the try catch block, because that helps you to if there's some exception is getting raised. So that helps you to understand the problem, to handle it and to find the solution. And that can be, because of anything. Maybe user is inserting the wrong data. Right? So I am using now try catch.
Okay.
And I will show you. to sir, please.
Yeah.
Line 24, catch. Expected, okay. So, yes.
It's
okay.
You opened another one.
Okay. Now, let's try to rerun our unit testing and let's see what exception we are getting and what message we are getting. Okay, Poornima, can you test the code now? Go to opportunity. No, it is already enabled. We have enabled for 24 hours.
Okay. For new opportunity for existing.
Search for different opportunity whose stage is something different but not close one.
How can I search it?
Give me the control. Okay, now though we have the, you know, the condition satisfied, but we are not getting the desired result. Now let's see what the problem actually we are getting. So this is the latest one. What now? Read this line very loud, everyone.
Yeah,
insert failed. First exception on row 0, first error, required field missing, required fields are missing, account name, account.
Okay, now I will tell you, but let me show you why I am getting this error. But our code has not, you know, the given any sort of the error message or something, you know, but we are not getting the result. So we have to find out, and we are, see here the account name, it is marked as required,
mandatory,
right? And what we have done,
we did not assign any value for account,
right? Yes, account. Okay, now let us go little bit deep level, where let's get the line number cause, okay, in our catch.
Prashant, can you explain try and catch?
Yes. I'm explaining you this thing.
Yeah. Okay. What I catch will do? No, I forgot. No changes here. Okay. Now I'm again making the stage name as a closed one, and I'm trying to create the contract again. Okay, now let's see what is the problem. Okay, line number
22.
Cause it is showing null. Then stack, it is telling line number 22, column 1, and at the line number 29, DML exception. Okay.
Yes.
So this means our insert is not working. Okay. So that means that something is, you know, is a problem in the during insert operation.
Okay.
Line 22, DML exception. And here require field missing, account name. So now you are getting the everything that, okay, required field is missing. That's why at line number 22, you are getting a DML exception. So if the required field is missing, let's give the data to this. Okay, and let's try once again. Now I'm making the condition satisfied. You are getting your contract here. Okay.
Yes.
And no exception raised. Now, what you have done actually, you have see this block. The entire operation in which you have doubt that user may create a problem, I mean the one who is entering the data may create a problem, you have covered that entire operation into try.
Okay.
Now, soon after the try, closing bracket, you have started your catch. I'm throwing a ball to you. You will catch it, right?
Yeah.
So, same way, in the entire operation, which I have covered in the try block, where a user can create a problem while entering the data, maybe whatever the problem. Wrong format or something, which even in the validation we are not covering. Okay, that will be catched by our catch block and will show you the message, line number, where you're getting the problem, and name, what sort of the problem you're getting. This makes you understand the problem and you can rectify the issue. If you were not using the try catch, let's say, now just imagine there's no try catch and I have not given the account ID, then your code is, you saved your code properly, no problem, you are able to see in the problems, okay, your code got saved now. But when you are testing your code, you're not getting the any, you know, the proper or desired result. you will be confused. Now there will be two things. Either you will give the system.debug statement, and you will read your code line by line, and you will see the value.
Mm-hmm.
But you have a try catch block here. You have given the whole operation inside a try, and you have a catch to show you the error. Any problem?
Oh. So the system debug cause, what will do? Or what is the cause it will show? Okay.
Why this particular operation is not performing? Will give you the cause. Line number, in the message you have seen the message, the what is the the problem.
Yeah.
In the message, insert field. Why?
Yeah.
Required field missing.
Yeah.
Which field? Account name. So everything is very clear here. Now at line number 22. Cause, it is saying the null.
Null.
And line number 29, DML exception. DML is not working. That's why the contract is unable to create. Your DML operation at line
22
is unable to perform because of the error message shown above, that the account ID is missing. Account is missing.
Okay.
Any problem in this? Poonima.
So it's providing some kind of data security, like we can know where the changes have been done.
I'm sorry, your statement?
It provides some kind of data security, right? Like
anything, there you are creating an application. So there can be, the n number of ways that your code, though it is not showing any problem while saving or, while running the operation, but the actual purpose is not getting solved. See, we have seen, right? We have saved our code and there was no problem as such. Secondly, when we are changing the value of the stage, at that time also, we were not able to find out the any sort of the error message on the screen. But the purpose is not getting satisfied, right? So that's the reason we have used the try catch, and that's the best practice for a developer.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. I have to ask you about why we are using try catch. Okay. Now it's.
Abhishek.
Yeah, Prashant.
So because you are into the Accenture, and you have seen that the lot of the code which we used to write is always in the try catch block.
Yes, Prashant.
Right?
Yeah.
So this is the best practice. And scenarios also you will find out the same in your professional life. You have to create some child record or some sort of update, made, delete, insert, etc. Okay, now write down one task.